people. Ninana silale, ningathi siyashota. Ngiyoqala, I want to appreciate the institution for organizing this event for the Black reconciliation, because this is something that we earnestly need as Africans. Now, the earlier speaker spoke about an African. In fact, he was saying even the white people are Africans, because humanity started here in Africa. Now, if humanity started here in Africa, it means even if a person is Chinese, he's an African. If that, we are, if siyamba ngalo understanding that humanity started here in Africa. Because the mistake that we are making is that we are making Ubu Africa being centered on the color of a skin rather than the state of a mind. We have a government that has been leading the country for the past 25 years. It is mostly led by black people. But if you look at the material conditions of the black people in the country, it clearly shows that there should be a distinction between black as well as being an African. You can have a black government, but engajongi, or that does not engajongi, that does not improve the material conditions of Africans. But immediately, if you've got an African government, I can assure you, the material conditions of all of the people in the country will be improved. Now, an African is a person, or I'm according to a value system. Utatu Kodi once spoke in our in some gathering. Uti, when you go to Germany, when you want to apply for citizenship there, even though you'll be given the ID, but you'll be made to write a test so that they can assess whether you are German also at heart. So it's not about just getting that green identity document that makes you to be a South African. You must be South African at heart by the values in which you need to live by. Now, the issue that we have in the country, or the problems that emanate from the constitution that we have, we can never be able to resolve all of these issues if we do not dismantle or destroy the constitution and have an African constitution. A constitution that is from us as Africans. It is something that is unheard of, that igqirha or isangoma cannot give a medical sick note in our own country. And that is allowed by a constitution here. Therefore, we can touch section 25 today, section 125 or whatever sections, but if we do not sit down and we call all of our inkosis zethu, abantu benkolo, sibahlaze phansi, including all of us as political parties, and we say this African country is South Africa, it must have this constitution that is a representation of the people. Because the constitution that we have was imposed on us. Hence you find Kukuba now, according to the constitution, it is illegal to spank your child. What did the African people say? They are saying this cannot be in our African country, that a parent, a iyaputwa from parenting, abantwana bakhe, which clearly shows there is a great discord between the constitution as well as the people of the country. We can talk and talk as much as we want, but if we do not fix this constitution, we are going nowhere. Lastly, I want to talk about the state of how we ought to relate with one another as the people of this country. The first thing that we need to destroy in our minds, it is hatred. Going back to my initial statement that says we are all Africans, you can never say we must hate a person because of their skin color. Because if you encourage the hating of white people, those white people will be dwelling in the urban areas. You as a black person in the township, you do not have access to those white people. Now, because you do not have access to the white people, you look for the next best thing to hate. And the next best thing to hate would be your fellow African brother. It would be another person from another tribe. Because racism, xenophobia, afrophobia, even tribalism are all feathers of the same bird. Therefore, Therefore, if you want to truly, truly liberate and transform our country, let us destroy the hatred of any form. Because once there's hatred, there's going to be violence. The violence that we see here, gender-based violence that we have in the country, it is a manifestation of the hatred that we have in our society. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is that we need to understand, we want to reclaim our country. But in the quest of us as Africans reclaiming our country, there are people that do not want to exist with us as Africans. And those people, we cannot allow our state particularly now. Because in each and every community, ukuba inkosi found ukuba umoshe kakhulu, it used to banish some other people baphume from the community because abakwazi ukuhlala nabanye abantu. So when you speak about the introduction, not the bringing back, but the introduction of a justice-based capital punishment system, in other words, the death penalty, we know for a fact there are other people in our country that do not want to coexist with other people. You can never justify the killing of 40 women and raping of 40 women by one person in just under 16 months. The problem that we have in the country, we are so hell-bent on justifying the actions of the perpetrator. We do not care at all about the victims. And I want to remind you, back in the day, amantombazana amancinci, including nomama, they used bambe, abangasentla benganxibanga nto. They used to show their breasts. And abanye, they used to show their thighs. But you never had rape. Because each and every man knew ukuba, you cannot just by seeing amathanga ufune urape your fellow sister. But currently, we are making that normal. Because we are saying, no, they must not be punished. What is wrong with this person? Maybe they are social or whatever circumstances that made this person to act like this. No, what we are saying to you as the ATM, we as this country, we need to have that accountability whereby if you do not want to live with other people, sikwele, it's easy as that. We cannot sihlale up and nurse the feelings of the perpetrators while you are dying. Because what's going to happen, this African country that we want, sizoya sibamba, because sizophela. So that is what we are saying. Let us have the introduction of a justice-based capital punishment system for those criminals that do not value human life. Because an African values human life. Immediately, as an African or any person, you do not want to coexist with other people. Thank you.